Hey everyone, my name is Wolver Leader, and in this video, we're going to take a look at the secret management building block in Dapr. Now, applications will need to store sensitive information in secrets using a dedicated secret store. This could include things like connection strings, keys, tokens, whatever we consider as secrets, in stores such as Azure Key Vault or AWS Secrets Manager. To access secrets, applications will usually include code that uses the secret store's specific SDK, which can add unnecessary boilerplate code into our application. Now, using the secret management building block in our Dapr applications, this makes it easier for us as developers to consume application secrets from a secret store. All we need to do is set up a component for a specific secret store and retrieve secrets using the Dapr Secrets API within our application codes. We can even reference secrets inside other Dapr component files, such as state stores and PubSub components. Now, there are a few features for Dapr secret management. We can actually, using the secrets management API building block, we can configure secrets without having to change our application code. We can also place credentials that we use for configuring Dapr components, such as PubSub and state management, using secret stores. This is actually considered best practice, as we don't want to store secrets in plain text within our component files and then commit those components in repos that would leak our secrets. We can also provide more granular control on access to secrets, because Dapr provides the ability to define scopes and restrict access permissions. To get a better understanding of how secrets work in Dapr, let's dive into some code to see how it works. So here I am in Visual Studio Code. And essentially what I've got here is a very basic console application that's going to retrieve a secret from a local store. So if I open up my CS proj file, all I'm using is this Dapr ASP.NET Core library. And then inside my program.cs file, I've got two constants. So I've got the name of the Dapr secret store, and I've also got a constant for the secret name. This is essentially the key that I'm going to be extracting or using to retrieve the secret from my local store. I instantiate a client using the new Dapr client builder.build method, and then I'm going to get the secret from the local store. So here I'm using this method getSecretAsync, and I'm passing through two parameters. So the name of my store that I've configured, along with the key for the secret. And then once that's successful, I'm going to print that to the console. Let's take a look at the component that we're using to configure our secret store. So if I click on localsecretstore.yaml in my components folder, I can see that I've got my secret store configured. So this is going to be a local secret store. So if I go back into my program.cs file, my name here, local secret store, matches the name that I've defined in this component's metadata. For the type, I've said that this is just going to be a local file, but there are different types of secret stores that you can use, including Azure Key Vault and AWS Secret Manager. And then I'm defining some metadata. So remember, depending on the type of resource or the service that you're using for your particular components, whether that be secret stores, state management, whatever, the metadata is going to be a little different. But here I'm saying that this secrets file is equal to secrets.json. And I've got that file in my secret message directory with a secret message. It's not actually that secret, but pretend this is a really secret value. So if I go back into my local store component, I can say that this is where my secrets are being stored. And I've got a nested separator, which is a comma. Now, if I open up a terminal, essentially I'm going to run this application using the Dapr run command. And it's very simple. I give my Dapr application ID, in this case, secret message, and then I'm pointing it to the resources path. So that components folder is where all of my components have been defined, which would be our local secret state store. Then I'm going to run it. We should see some Dapr logs. And then hopefully when the secret's retrieved, it has retrieved the message for us. You are awesome. So it's retrieved our secret, which is pretty neat. Now, one of the great features of the secrets management building block in Dapr is that we can call the secrets API in our application code to retrieve and use secrets from Dapr supported secret stores. And we can configure secrets without having to change the application code. So if I go back into Visual Studio Code, what I'm going to do is I'm going to open up my secrets.json file. And imagine this is a connection string, or better yet, a primary key that we're using as part of authentication to a remote resource like a database. And we have in place a policy to rotate those keys. So instead of having to change our application code to accommodate this, we can actually instead change the secrets, and we don't need to make any changes to our secret store component, nor do we have to make changes to our application code. So what I'm going to do, so you are okay, change the secret message to that, go back into the terminal, run that application again, and this time we should see, hopefully, our new message, so our new secret value, you are okay. So rather than having to change anything in our application code, all we've done is change the secret itself, and our Dapr application has picked up the new secret value. Now there is a trick with secrets management in Dapr. We can actually use scoping to limit the secrets that can be read by your application from secret stores. The way that we configure this is by using another building block in Dapr called configuration. And that's what we'll talk about in our next video. But for now, let's wrap this up. So that wraps up this video. In this video, we learned how the secrets management building block works in Dapr, and we saw how we can use it to retrieve secrets that are configured in secret store components using the Dapr SDK. In our next video, we're going to take a look at the configuration building block and how we can use that to deal with application configuration for our Dapr applications. So if you like this video, give it a like. If you have any questions on Dapr, please ask in the comment section below. And if you want to see more videos on Dapr, don't forget to subscribe. No matter where you are in the world, I hope you're having a great day, and we'll see you all next time.